Sir, our today's theme is Dare to Dream. Mm-hmm. So, we got to know that you have a very interesting story to tell. So
yeah,
please share.
In fact, I'll tell you that you have the theme rakha, Dare to Dream, when I got a mail. Mila. So, I was really very keen to join this because I also had dared to dream. Because, you know, many people have dreams, but very few dare to dream.
Right, right. So, what is that story?
Story is that, you know, I was an employee of an organization.
Okay. Which
started working in 1989, but due to certain reasons, that company came to a stage of bankruptcy.
Okay.
And the owners, they were old, and the next generation was not too keen to manage those companies, and company came to a stage of closure.
Okay.
And there, thanks to government departments, particularly state of Uttar Pradesh government, they supported me.
Okay.
And we created a strategy that let us convert this dead unit into a buzzing unit.
Okay.
And this story started somewhere in 2002.
Okay.
You know, at that time our company was having a sales turnover around 13 crores and having unpaid debts of around 55 crores.
Okay.
But
this was in year?
Year in 2002.
2002, okay.
Okay. And you know, there is a rehabilitation procedure designed by government, like today's NCLT.
Okay.
In those days, it was BIFR.
Okay.
So the rehabilitation took over. And then eventually, supported by banks, supported by all our employees, we really started the journey. And the journey is that today, a company which was dead, company which had a turnover of only 13 crores.
Okay.
Last year, we closed a turnover of almost 200 crores. We closed precisely 193 crores.
Okay, great.
And in this real journey of 15 years, as I said, I had dared to
dream.
But we tried it, created a strategy. Okay, look, if there is a willingness, why cannot do it?
100%. Yeah.
And my first motto which I put on my wall when I signed the agreement with the government, that no war is lost until you stop trying.
Right.
And from there we took on, a company was on the bottom of the line product doing aftermarket business for low-end vehicles. Today we are supplying product to companies like BMW, and KTM and Kubota, and as the leading brands in the world.
Okay.
Now in this, the biggest thing which we did, first of all, we had trust on ourselves.
Okay.
Because behind any journey, if you take, until you are confident in yourself, nobody else will be confident.
Yeah.
And then there was a very challenging task in front of us to upgrade the technology, to create the right kind of people. You know, only technology alone cannot work.
Okay.
Only people alone cannot work.
Right.
There has to be a balance of the right skilled people, motivated team, and the right mix of technology. Now both this put together, then end of the day is customer.
Nothing is impossible.
Yes, yes. Then nothing is possible. And customer has to actually have confidence on you, have trust on you, and then you have to deliver what you have committed. You know, from my side, when we decided, okay, we have to restructure the entire business, so we decided aftermarket is not the future, because the product which we were, that was no more a consumer product. We were actually into the breakdown product. Road conditions improved, Motor Vehicle Act was new, so eventually, because we produce in deal in gears.
Okay.
So gears was a breakdown item. If some truck breaks down, only then the gear is changed. It's not a brake, or it's not a shock absorber.
Right.
It has particular life. Then we decided where to go. And India market was really buzzing in those days, but there was a little less room for new entrants to enter the domestic market. That was the time when European manufacturers were looking at India. And we stepped in at the right time. We started interacting with them, and thank God, thank our team, and thank our initiatives and their strategy. Customers started posing confidence in us. And first customer was, you know, Japan.
Okay.
We started exporting to Kubota tractors in Japan.
So you first came into export, then in the local manufacturing?
Yeah, yeah. No,
okay.
Even then we were in local manufacturing, but in a minuscule level. Mainly we were in aftermarket, but in tier one segment we were dealing with the some Indian manufacturers like Yamaha or Piaggio.
So, sir, from 2002 at 13 crores to in 2019 at nearly 200 crores.
Yeah.
What is your biggest learning experience and corporate mantra that you want to give to young entrepreneurs for these 17 years that you have learned?
Yeah, you are right, right. First of all, the patience and perseverance.
Okay.
Duly supported by the right kind of strategy.
Okay.
You know, when we started entering into exports market, we really analyzed our product. We analyzed our manufacturing capabilities. Then we found where there is a room, we should sell our product. Okay. Because we were not into mass markets. Like Indian two-wheeler manufacturers, they're producing millions of motorbikes per year. So you need huge investment. So we were a company which was not having very strong financials. So for us, we needed a segment where there is a need for niche product, mid-volume, but high quality.
Okay. So patience is the key to success.
Patience is the key to success, because biggest thing is patience, but first of all, the right strategy. Okay. Because if your strategy is wrong, patience will not work. Eventually, it will end up in frustration. Okay. But if you have the right strategy and you do not have the patience, then you will not be able to have
combo of both.
It has to draw a balance. Okay. And we really learned that both these two things, patience and the right strategy, really helps the industry to grow in a big way. And message to next generation, the coming generation, is that first of all, believe in manufacturing. Because it's my opinion, maybe right or wrong, but I personally feel today's generation believes more in service sector.
Okay.
Whether it is IT or whether it is finance or so on. But I personally feel no country can grow until there is a strong manufacturing base. If we historically look at the developed nations, starting from UK to France to Germany to US, they were all into manufacturing and off late the China. And this is my message, and I feel believe in manufacturing. Growing manufacturing in India has a very big future in life.
We hope so. Thank you, sir. Thank you for your valuable inputs.